the bizarre climate you have here in Cloistra. First snow and now threatening storm. The gods must be angry.
God must be angry, not gods, Neville. We use the singular here in England.
What a storm for Christmas Eve.
Yes. It was like this the night when Rosa's mother died.
Neville tells me you were once engaged to Rosa's mother, Mr. Crisparkle.
Yes, but I'm afraid I was a bit too Anglican. Too angular for her taste. And then, at the seaside party, celebrating her second anniversary, only a few months after Rosa's birth, she slipped. Well, walking unobserved along the cliffs and drowned to the embrace of the ungrateful waves. But enough. Let us follow Mr. Jasmine's lead and forget our grievances with life and each other over a sturdy Christmas dinner.
I pray you will forgive the meager merits of my humble table.
Hello, all sorry the late will be
possible. It's wondrous to see you again. Let me take your things.
I had no idea you were taking on domestic stuff, Uncle. Edwin, Mr. Landis will take you seriously.
No fear of that.
Now, lads. Rosa, you have no idea what it means to have you in my chambers.
Miss Bud, how is it that the season of holly, you remind me of the flowering hibiscus?
And how does it remind me of an inconsistent baker? Why, your metaphors are quite stale. Your manners seem uncommonly fresh.
You go too far!
Please, this is Christmas Eve and I will tolerate no further unchristian-like behavior between the two of you. Now, this mulled wine is very good stuff indeed. I had it prepared especially for you from a recipe I obtained on a recent trip to London.
Well, any port in the storm for me, Uncle.
Yes, any port in the storm. Very good, Edwin, very good. None for me, thanks!
Now let us drink deep.
This wine seems more potent than usual, Dad.
Well, I thought you lads would like it. Let's have no more ill will between you.
Please, Edwin. There's no longer any call for rivalry between us, Neville. You have my friendship if you wish.
And Merry Christmas to you, Edwin.
The goose is cooked.
It's fine. I believe you're going to have to cook this dinner when we eat it.
Why, your blandness, perhaps you should accompany us to Cairo. I'm sure Rose and I could use someone to carry our bags.
What?
Someone better acquainted with a foreign town than he is with minding his own.
Gentlemen, ladies, please be seated.
Sir, I don't much like your talk. Let's see what's in this name you wear. Lady, you wear a fine cup and fine and run a waistcoat. One can soon be told. Baggage suit and baggage feet on you.
Something in this speech seems ominous to me.
Pray I propose a toast to Rosa, Bud, and Edwin through three cheers.
But here's the roast.